When traffic control does not go as planned, sometimes the tower controller complains to the radar controller, and the radar controller complains to the tower controller. There are various reasons for the complaint and disharmony, such as not assigning the approach sequence as requested, rejected a request for no reason, and different interpretations of the same regulation. In the last tower controller versus radar controller video, we looked at the fundamental characteristics of tower controllers and radar controllers. In this video, let's go a step further and see how differently they accomplish their tasks. Please watch this fully so our warm message can be delivered into your hearts. 1. Asking the tower controller versus the radar controller. There is a lot of knowledge about air traffic control that tower controllers and radar controllers alike need to know. However, each of them have a more specialized field. Tower controllers have a detailed layout of the airport in their head. Runways, taxiways, and ramps can be drawn even with their eyes closed. They are well aware of the equipment installed around the runway, the type of airport lighting system, the waiting area for the ground rescue team, and the mountains and buildings around the airport. In short, they know the airport like the back of their hands. So when there is a fire around the airport, many people call the control tower and ask, "Where is the smoke coming from?" On the other hand, radar controllers know the instrument procedures for landing and departure like the back of their hands. For example, instrument procedure for each navigation aids, the altitude to be maintained by distance from the airport, holding patterns, minimum vectoring altitude, blind area, airway and passing altitude of the fix, etc. They are experts on instrument charts. If a pilot who is making an instrument flight to an airport for the first time wants to ask about the instrument approach procedure, he can ask the radar controller. 2. Runway change. The direction of a runway depends on the tower controller's decision. A tower controller has to monitor the wind's direction and velocity in real time and continuously check the weather forecast. At the airport where the wind changes its direction frequently, the runway direction also changes several times. Overall, the tower controller considers not only the wind, but also the traffic situation, navigation aids, and visibility for the change in runway. Once the runway change is decided, the tower controller informs not only departing aircrafts, but the staff on the ground, weather station and airport operations center, etc. On the other hand, a radar controller has to set the vector of all aircrafts in the opposite direction. This makes the controller busy instructing new heading and altitude to each aircraft. If the runway is changed with the aircrafts already lined up on the final approach route, the controller will be enough to embarrass. Of course, the most important factor in runway change is wind. However, it is necessary for the tower controller to cooperate and communicate the traffic situation with the radar controller. 3. When the weather is bad. With bad weather, the radar controller gets busier. In this situation, an aircraft will likely fail to land and try approaching again, even several times. When the weather is too bad to land, an aircraft has to hold in the sky until the weather becomes better. Especially in the case of cumulonimbus in the root of an aircraft, the aircraft demands deviation either to the left or the right. Thus, on bad weather, communication increases sharply, and it is hard to assign approach sequence as well. Then, what difficulty will the tower controller, who controls watching the aircraft and the runway directly instead of the radar scope, encounter on bad weather? Firstly, it is likely that the tower controller does not notice ground staff or vehicles on the runway. It is awful to imagine the plane taking off or landing on a runway where there are people and vehicles. Secondly, the pilot might not be able to identify and go beyond the hold line on the ground, which can lead to a runway incursion. Therefore, the tower controller needs to get reported and check the plane's location incessantly. Besides, there are many risk factors in a touchdown phase, such as strong wind, bad braking action, and the pilot not being insightful of the runway. So, the tower controller and the radar controller will be both sensitive on bad weather. 4. When controlling an emergency aircraft. radar controllers immediately conduct emergency broadcast and notify the tower controller. They check the intentions of the pilot, including the nature of emergency, the number of passengers, amount of fuel remaining, type of approach and landing runway, and deliver these to the tower controller. They separate other aircrafts from the emergency aircraft so that enough distance can be maintained. All aircrafts except emergency aircraft are instructed to hold in the sky until the emergency is over. In a limited space, providing sufficient separation between holding aircrafts not only makes traffic more complicated, but radar controllers must constantly communicate with pilots. Tower controllers deliver the emergency situation to the ground rescue team by using crash bell and crash phone as soon as possible. Fire trucks, ambulances, and tow cars are placed near the runway by the tower controller. They control the aircraft's taxiing on the ground so that the vehicles assisting the emergency can proceed first. Considering the position of the emergency aircraft and the landing runway, they instruct the departing aircrafts to hold on the taxiway or ramp. It is also the task of the control tower to check if there is anything wrong with the runway where the emergency aircraft landed, and to safely withdraw the ground rescue team. The tower controllers also have to respond to numerous inquiry calls from the airport officials and airline workers regarding the emergency situation. While watching so far, could you feel that both the tower controller and the radar controller are doing their best in their situation? When a dangerous situation occurs, anyone can think, "I tried my best and the situation worsened because the controller of the other unit did not perform well." However, what controller would want the aircrafts to fall in danger? We are all just trying our best in a given situation. People always view the world in their own perspective, and the difference in perspectives creates trouble. Tower controllers and radar controllers are just one team who have a common goal of aviation safety, and this goal can be reached by communicating and understanding each other. We will end this video by quoting a script from the Disney animation Zootopia. The more we try to understand each other, the more we embrace each other's differences. ATC for you.